back. Seems like I just finished, but sharing with you guys the bookstore I See Me, and I'm going to show you the books, some of the books that I have purchased and have been using for Bible with the kids. And I don't know, just depending on how long that video is, I may tack this one on. If not, I'll put it up separately. Hopefully I can remember to do it in order, because knowing me, it may be April if I forget. Charge it to my head, not my heart. But okay, let me show you the Bibles. So okay, there goes my phone. Alright, so yeah, stack of Bibles. This one, as you can see, is quite tattered and torn, but this was a Bible that I grew up with. This was my mom's Bible. She did replace this Bible, and it was a white one, and I also had the white one. It's white and gold, and I think I had this one too. Now, if you guys have been following, you know how we lost belongings, and it so happened the reason why I didn't lose it is because when we were moving, I stuck it in my truck, so this one didn't get lost. And I haven't, I don't mess with it too much. It still has the same papers and things that she had in it, the way I took from her, cleaning out her stuff. But I'm gonna try to, I had to put a little note in here for the kids so they know not to handle it roughly, and to, in case of a fire, grab the Bible. But yeah, we don't write in our Bible. I don't know. I think a few of them she did, but it just has a little family heritage thing, who was presented to and all of that. But I have a thing about writing in books. I have a hard time writing in notebook paper. But yeah, you can see the coloring is like an antique paper. And it pretty much has the maps, African presence in the Bible, and all of the territories and things charted out. My son, Javen, is where his name is derived from. So I guess I kind of remember that when growing up, reading this is where I came up with his name. But so very easy to understand. Family of Abraham, family tree. Some harmony of the Gospels. Get rid of the shadow. Maybe if I sit and kind of hold it this way, well, it's a little bit better. So it breaks it down by the time period, and then Jesus' final week of work at Jerusalem and 40 events. So it tells you, you know, everything leading up, where to find it, by the day. Index. This one actually does not have the Apocrypha in it. The white one had the Apocrypha in it. And that's what I used to study from. So, pass all of this. There's Zion. And get you to some. I'm trying to get to the pictures. But, somebody's feet print are stuck in here. I have no idea. I don't know if it's labeled or not. Oh, that's not important. Oh, that's Aaliyah. For some reason, one of my kids' pictures. And that picture stuck in there. You guys probably have seen a million times. And that is her picture. It's a picture of my grandmother and her siblings. This is my grandmother, my mom's mom. So, very old photo. So that's in there. Old program from Lord knows when. Probably from the 80s, I'm sure. 97, or the, yeah, that's what I meant, the 90s, 97. All right, the pictures are kind of mixed up. Here we go. Throughout, children's illustrated Bible stories in the middle. Adam and Eve with the kente paper. So it kind of breaks down Adam and Eve and lets them memorize a scripture. There's Noah's Ark. There's Noah and the animals. Tower of Babel. Joseph and his brothers. Moses and the Pharaoh's daughters. Moses at the Red Sea. And I've seen this. I want this print to display on the wall. Joshua in the Battle of Jericho. Like I said, biblically correct characters are very hard to find in resources, but you have to look. David and Goliath, the birth of Jesus. The boy, Jesus in the temple. Jesus feeds the crowds. Jesus walks on the sea. Jesus brings a young girl back to life. The story of Talitha Kumi, which is very significant to me in my life. I may share with you guys one day. Jesus carries the cross. Jesus rises from the dead. And then here are the favorite Bible stories and all of the illustrators in here. Paul L. Treese is the illustrator. And let's get you some more pictures. Thing. This is African American. What am I trying to say? Illustrators. You have Romare Bearden, Aaron Douglas, Malvin Gray Johnson, William Henry Johnson, Walter Williams. Henry Osawa Tanner, James Porter. So just a little bio And I think we have a couple of books with these portraits, their artwork is what I'm trying to say in them. Very nice pieces. Here's one by Walter Williams. It's called Roots. Building More Stately Mansions by Aaron Douglas. Here is Going to Church by William Henry Johnson. Henry Oswald Tanner, The Three Marys. Noah's Ark. Over here, The Last Supper. Sorry guys, I need to hold the camera back. Woman with Jug, James Amos Porter. Dixie Madonna by Melvin Gray Johnson. This is based on Proverbs 4 and 3. This one's based on John 4, 13 and 14. And this is a little bio on James Wells and the Students of Harlem Art Workshop. Religious Aspirations by James Wells, based on Micah 6 and 8. Fish and Water, Psalms 139, 9 and 10. A Princess, Artist Unknown, based on Song 4 and 9. Beautiful. Fish is so detailed. I used to stare at these pictures all day. Mother and Child, Artist Unknown. Proverbs 31, 28, verse through 30. Boy in Haystack, Artist Unknown. Matthew 11 and 28. And we have Mary Quite Contrary. Doris Scott, age 12. Based on Luke 12:27. All right, let's get you back here. Unchanging Land of the Bible, and it just basically talks about how things were changed and the troops were robbed. So, even though it, you know, the information is old, it's always new, but it's good to know the new in truth. So, here's some old, the side of Jesus's crucifixion. Get rid of that. Mount Evil, The Burning Bush, Garden of Gethsemane, what else? The Tomb of the Virgin Mary, Nazareth, Upper Room on Mount Zion, Church. This is where they had the Last Supper. Of course, everybody knows camels are used. The Tomb of Lazarus, home of Abraham and Isaac. Get you out of shadow. Wheat harvest. Dead Sea at sunrise. There we go. Just beautiful. Famous Cedars of Lebanon. And here's the Exodus. Breaks down all the empires. Paul Paul's Journey to Rome. And is there anything else significant in here? The Words of Christ. Oh, excuse me. There's a nice dictionary back here. Very, very nicely done to be old. And like I said, old. I remember this Bible from, gosh, I can't, I don't want to, it had to be in the 80s, and probably before that. God is gracious in May, so. That is it. Let's see, did I skip anything in the front? I guess that was it. Pretty much, but there's that. And like I said, I grew up reading this one and the other ones. I'm getting ready to show you a couple more. Yeah, that was it. I think there's something in here about how to study. But yeah. Alright, and then the next one is the African American Family Heirloom Bible. Move it along. And they know to be careful with this one as well. Like I said, we don't write in them out of habit. African influence in the scripture. The creation story. The origins of African people, Ham, sons of Ham, like the borders around the pages, Ham and his descendants, in the King James Version text. So everything is broken down in subject, scripture, from these roots. We used to have this print hanging on the wall. The role of the Bible in the civil rights movement. Guide for religious workers and Bible teachers. Okay, that's the one. Yeah. So, how to study the Bible. For business, for baptism, for backsliders, for assurance, just all sorts of things. Christian living, Christianity and the Antichrist, doubters for excuses, that type of thing, where you would want to go for confessions, when you're faced with those type of issues, excuses, forgiving, hypocrites. So yeah, for love, personal work, for the revival, for the repentance, for prayer, all broken down, for salvation, for Sabbath. Ooh, everything in alphabetical order. Spirituality, Sunday. So, talks about the true Sabbath and why Sunday is not. The four Gospels. The harmony of the four Gospels in alphabetical order. The miracles. Here's a daily calendar for reading the Bible. and the first book of Moses called Genesis. Pictures, family album. If you are one to want to keep those type of things in your Bible, they have that. Like I said, we don't tend to do that. Celebration of Kwanzaa. So it tells you all about the celebration. You can record other celebrations and traditions that you have in your family. And this one pretty much I'm trying to get to the back. It's not too much, it's not too descriptive like the other one with the pictures, but still a good one. These are not as vivid. They're pretty much old school. So that's why I prefer that one. And this other one that I'm going to show you. But, still nice to have. And it's good to see how Bibles are evolving. Been nice if some of these were in color, but still good to have those included nonetheless than none at all. In the dictionary. Alright. Let's see, lots and lots. There's a scripture atlas. And let me move you to the next one. Oops. Alright, this one. Like I said, this one is just fairly new. And I think it's still on back order because they put out so many at a time. And so they're backlogged until the end of the end of March, I think. So I'll probably end up getting another one, but I didn't want to be greedy. So this one, they also know to be careful turning the pages, and it's just the bottom of his robe down there. So this is going to be great because we are going to be covering, according to my lesson plan, Israel. In our Galloping the Globe, our unit study towards, I think, the 1st of April. So it's going to be great to be able to use this. The First Testament, the love of the Father, house rules and the rebellious son, the foundation, and it gives you all of the books. Noah's Ark, the family tree, Abraham and his generations, the foundation, the Exodus, what it says up here. I'm trying to hold it up that way I see a little bit better. The only thing that I wish that this Bible included is the Apocrypha. It would have been very nice with an Apocrypha. But nonetheless, it is nicely done. I don't know, the minor is the pages being so thin, you can see through, see the imprint of the other side. That's the only other thing that's kind of, I don't know, it could be a little tedious, but it's livable. The Chronicles, yes, here's the Chronicles of Israel. Israel divided. Joshua. Let's see. This is back here. There's another Bible like this, a little more secular. But it is also for children. It's awesome too. It's not completely correct, but it's a good resource. And I don't have that one. I'm thinking about getting that one too. But it's done in comic book form by I want to say from is he Spanish? It's a Spanish author. Yeah, from Spain, I think. So I of course want biblically correct, but especially on this, but I do teach children everything. I expose them to all cultures, as long as it's not evil. The prophets of Israel, Elisha's ascension, Jonah, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, Ezekiel, Daniel and the Lion's Den. My kids love to read this story. The prophets. They love Joshua too. The Gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus raises the dead. John. The goats and the sheep. Jesus rebukes. The sacrificial lamb. Praying in the Garden of Gethsemane. Peter's vision. Okay, let you see the print on that. And it is, like I say, it's very, my camera is very sharp. But it's very, the pages are very blurry type. See if I can focus in on that. I think it really, really close. But if you're holding it from afar, they don't look very clear. I guess the color on when it gets to those pages. But these are a little bit clearer. Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Thessalonians. Alright. And so, Messenger of the Word, and the Revelation. Very nice picture. Very nice. The vision of John. There's that, and then the trumpets. Culture at a glance. Talks about the lamb, the incense, the colors, the candlestick, the meanings of significant things. Alright, let me move it along. Here is the book on the creation.
Oh, I just
print the pictures in this one so that we can preserve it, but There's their store logo. Helping children see themselves in history. And it has a alphabetical order worksheet about the creation or the foundation. And a word search. A naming word, noun, person, place, or thing. The earth is round. God is in lives in heaven. That type of thing. He made the whole world. Underline the action word. The verb. Write a complete sentence using the words. Ran, angel, the. Draw a line from the beginning to the endings. So, lots of ways to teach. And, I mean, you can use this as a starting point, introducing things, your lessons, and things like that. But the kids love these books. They just love to look at them. Even this one not being in color, because they bring it to life when they color. It's practicing grammar. So, and then here is the storybook. I wish these were hardback though. I mean, they're holding up pretty good. And so I will bring you guys back and show you when the other stuff, when the things arrive that I'm buying, I'll show you. They'll be enjoying that stuff while we are on a spring break. So, and then here's one on, let's see. There we go. It is written, The Birth of a King. And here is the president of the company. So as you see, pictures are correct. Move it up like that. Glossy pictures. Yeah, I like to go to the store about once a month and add things if I don't find them on eBay. Some things I can find on eBay, and of course I'm going to find it for the best price. So they may have it in this store, but if I can find it on eBay for cheaper, which usually I can, I will buy it from there. But I do like to support them. Like I said, hopefully I will remember. So many videos. But in any case, I will link the two of them together so that you can see the other video. So share with me any resources that you use to teach Bible with your littles, whether you homeschool or not, because I do believe the Bible is the foundation of the home. So, on that note, be blessed.